So welcome back to Mid Morning Live. I'm Deanne Mohammed, and joining me on set is Vashti Miraj, and she produces the Central Beat magazine. It's a quarterly magazine, I must say, very interesting. And let's chat with Vashti about why she's doing this. Welcome.
Thank you so much for having me.
So it's interesting that you put out a free, it's a free quarterly magazine.
Yes. We started about 2 years ago, so at the beginning of 2014 we started. The idea was, behind it all, was to celebrate Central, because we found that what was happening generally in the society was that Central was never really a focus for any media in the country. Okay. So even if we got mentioned as an entity in the national media, it usually had to do with the...
But it's a big shopping center.
So you get a business story out of Central, you'd get a Diwali Nagar story out of Central, and an occasional chutney story.
That's it.
And then some crime and so on. But it just was not celebrating Central. There's a lot of hidden talent, there's a lot of amazing people, there's a lot of events, there's a lot of things happening.
I just want to put a plug for Central. I'm from Central originally. I'm a Coover girl, so I know exactly what you're talking about. The people from Central are very talented.
That's right.
And need to be celebrated.
That's right.
Okay. That's a little plug for Central people, yes.
Mm-hmm. So that's how we started out, with that idea that we would, you know, because Central people are not accustomed to seeing themselves reflected in the national media, I thought it was important that we started doing that in a serious way. And so we started in the beginning of 2014, and we have quarterly issues, which means every, you know, there's 4 issues that come out each year. Mm-hmm. And well, we just had our, we're now doing our next issue, our first issue for 2016, which will be out at the end of February. And you know, so the background is really about celebrating, highlighting, putting information out there that shows that Central exists, that we have a right to exist, and that we have important and relevant things.
But Sun Shagwan has been like the, like, I mean, people leave all over Trinidad to come to Shagwan as a shop because they find it the cheapest places to get any kind of goods.
That's right.
And yet we're not giving them that kind of attention, you think?
I think the attention is really more related to perhaps there's an occasional business story and you know, certain other things, but it doesn't highlight the people the way that we think the people need to be highlighted. There are people with so many interesting stories, whether they're a vendor in the market or they started a business from scratch in Central, because Central has a lot of entrepreneurial spirit.
Yes.
Because of the years of neglect of Central, you found that people were more entrepreneurial in terms of, you know, starting new businesses and so on in order to survive and to grow and to thrive. And so there's a lot of that in Central. So there's a lot of great stories from rags to riches, or taking a small company into a massive entity and so on. So there's a lot of great stories to be told, and we just felt it was necessary to tell it at this time.
So you have a full staff, you have writers, you have...
I have freelancers.
Okay.
So we just really, we are more home-based.
Okay.
So we build the paper on our own, basically. I have a graphic artist who does it and so on for me. And then the Trinidad Guardian does the actual publishing.
Okay.
And it's inserted in the Guardian when it does come out, and then we take it around to different parts of Central, different points that we drop off the paper to, and let people know where they can get it. And I think we've been able to achieve a good product.
Well, 2 years is a, mm-hmm. is a while, and
mm-hmm.
and doing it like freelancing from home, so
yes.
That is not like you're in communication every day, so that you have, you're building on ideas from each other.
Mm-hmm.
So that's interesting. And so every quarter you bring out a magazine.
Yeah.
But the topics, the things you cover, it's such a wide area. So we could discuss some of it, because I find
yeah.
it very interesting that you touch, but I find it's a little biased towards women. So we could also talk about that.
I try to be biased towards women. No, because I'm female, obviously there's an initial bias. And because I'm trained in gender,
okay.
So my master's
That's
is in gender
yeah.
studies, so I understand the issues of, you know, how women have not had access to the things that they should have had access to all these years. So I understand the issues that women have faced, and I tend to put out issues that I think women would be interested in, but it's not something that I'm, you know, committed to doing for the rest of the magazine. I really want to take the magazine to men as well, So we do try to insert a lot of different things for men from time to time, whether it's about cars. We have sports, you know, we have someone who writes about sports issues for us, and we do put sporting material in relevant to men, not just women. And, you know, we have tech, we are interested in hearing from men as well what they would like to read. So we do try, but we are starting to open up more to getting more men on board to write more. We're trying to get some men to write columns and so on, and to write more articles. So we're trying to balance it out. But yes, initially there has been a bias because I'm female, and it does come out in what I put
out there. Well, in everything, because like if you go shopping, like you say Mother's Day is more celebrated than Father's Day. Mm-hmm. So the bias is towards women for marketing and for products.
Yes.
So I guess, and I think women read more. They seem to make the time to read.
I think so. And plus, I think, I mean, even beyond that, you know, the actual holding of a newspaper in your hand to read is still something that's relevant to people in Trinidad and Tobago right now. To bring in to another issue, I mean, I know we have competition from online magazines, and, you know, a lot of people are going online.
Yeah.
But we think that the central community still appreciates this newspaper in their hand to read, and it's we try to make it as vibrant as possible and as appealing as possible to the eye.
Mm-hmm.
So we, you know, we committed to having a physical product, but we also maintain a product online as well through our Facebook page, so people can have access.
Oh, you have it online as well?
We are on Facebook. So my Facebook page is a little different to the actual paper in that we put information.
Not everything.
From the paper. Oh. On the Facebook, we do. Everything we put, we upload the whole paper onto the Facebook page. But what we try to do with the Facebook page as well is make it into a sort of a news site.
Okay.
So we gather interesting news from different national media, and we upload it onto the Facebook page. So people who are not necessarily reading all the regular newspapers or know what's going on in the country can have a place that they can go to and say, oh, well, this is happening in Trinidad, this is happening in Central, you know, and try to make it, you know, make the national news and the Central news more accessible to people in Central.
That's good, because I probably could help you with some male topics that could be very, I guess everybody could share in it. And, I'll talk to my person and find out he's willing to share his story, because it's a human interest story too.
Mm-hmm.
And it's about fitness, and I think everybody could benefit from it.
Absolutely. Well, that's, I try to, in fact, I do include a fitness story in every edition, because I think we have an issue amongst East Indians generally about, you know, in terms of diabetes, heart issues,
correct,
obesity. And so I try to include health issues in every edition so that people know how they can get healthier. And I try to include a workout, a fitness workout that is easy, that is simple, and that people could just look at and follow so that, you know, they get inspired to do something.
I think Vashti should come and be my co-host, the way she's sounding, just like me, trying to build people's health, your wellness, and change the way you think about your lifestyle and what's happening in your life. Sounds like a very positive. We could probably talk about one or two of your topics in the magazine. What we'll do, we'll take a break. When we come back, we'll just skim through one or two of them, and you'll see the kind of topics she covers in the magazine. Back in a minute.